Good morning, everyone. This morning, we welcome Mrs. McDonald and members of the Lower Six who are going to give us a talk on Mental Health Awareness Week. Please take your seats.
So, good morning. This week is Mental Health Awareness Week, as Mr. Craddock just mentioned, and the theme for Mental Health Awareness Week this year is loneliness. Now, not something maybe that you would associate with mental health issues, but something which has seen a sharp increase since the pandemic for quite obvious reasons in all age groups, not just in the elderly who are obviously on their own at home potentially, but also in younger people. So last week, Mr. Jewell gave us an excellent assembly on resilience. And this assembly kind of follows on from that and allows us to create a kind of toolbox of strategies to combat some mental health issues that we might face. So I'm going to hand over to my Lower Six students, who are going to talk a little bit more about it.
What do we mean by loneliness? Loneliness is often described as when we feel we do not have the meaningful relationships we want around us. 10% of young people say they often feel lonely. This can be in friendships, family relationships, or romantic relationships at school, home, or work.
Short-term and long-term loneliness. Many of us feel lonely from time to time. Sometimes we can feel lonely for longer periods of time. If you are ever feeling lonely, you can go and speak to your form tutors, the school nurses, or the school counsellor. Or if you'd rather speak to a student and you're in year seven, you can talk to your big sister in the sixth form, or you can speak to our head girl team. Your friends are there to support and comfort you, so never forget they care about how you're feeling. Social isolation is the physical separation from the people and the things that bring us comfort and support. However, it is still easy to feel lonely even if you're surrounded by people. We're now going to watch a short video about love.
Sometimes I feel pretty lonely. When I go out, I just wish I was back home in my room gaming. Then everything becomes harder. Like, I've skipped a tutorial on how to be a person. And now I'm just pushing random buttons and it's not working, which makes it worse. Then I remember, I'm not alone. I just need to give it another go. And who knows, maybe they know that feeling too.
Not a mental health problem, it is an experience that can affect our mental health.
It might make us feel isolated or angry at others. We could feel disconnected from the world around us, and this could worsen the state of our mental well-being.
Connecting with ourselves. When experiencing emotional loneliness, finding ways to connect with ourselves can be helpful. For example, we can practice mindfulness, listen to music and dance, journal, practice yoga, paint, try something new, or do something that you're good at. Social loneliness is a feeling like you do not have the supportive relationships you would want in your life. It can take time to build meaningful connections with others. To help you connect with others, you could always call or text a friend, offer a hug to someone you care for, do an activity with someone, join a new club or activity, or speak to a trusted adult.
Existential loneliness is feeling a lack of connection to the world around us. So for an example, you can go for a walk, read a book or watch TV, take on a new responsibility and show kindness to the world around us. Top tips for looking after ourselves when feeling lonely. Be kind to ourselves. Find ways of expressing how we feel through art, music or sport.
We can talk to someone or do something that we enjoy. You can spend time with those who support you, whether that be friends or family. And or you can find people with similar interests to you. There are so many clubs around school. Why not find one you like?
Be mindful of the media that we look at. Like during lockdown, we might have been using lots more social media than usual, which could have negatively affected our mental health. Show gratitude and kindness to ourselves and others.
Okay, thank you, Lewis, for talking to us about loneliness. So remember that if you are experiencing any of these feelings, you've got people that can support you. So you've got your form tutors, you've got pastoral teams, you've got friends. If you're feeling low or sad about anything to do with that, then you can come and see any of us. So I'm now going to pass over to Mr. Craddock.
Thank you, Mrs. McDonald. Thank you, Lower Six. Please can you show your appreciation for that excellent and important talk. We have some math challenge success certificates to give out. The upper five certificates are in their folders, so they will not be here, but I would like you to applaud them anyway. But the following, what we'll do, if when I read the names out, if you could sort of queue up here, starting from here, and when they move forward to receive the certificate from Mrs. McDonald, if then you could applaud, otherwise it becomes inaudible. So, math challenge success. We have had success at the intermediate math challenge. This is a national math challenge with 20 girls receiving certificates. Congratulations go to the following girls. Bronze certificates go to the following upper fives: Yeva Danilko, Emily Leung, Maisie O'Shea. In lower five, if they could come up, please. Shakira Betancourt, Vinci Chan, Daisy Dean, Cara Ho, Lily Langley, Agnes Lee, Holly Roberts, Francis Todd, and Bernice Yao. Silver certificates go to Ariella Gerson, Jaden's Q, who are in upper five. And in lower five, Zilia Sue and Heidi Yao. And gold certificates go to the following upper five girls who all qualified for the follow-on round due to their very high scores: Rose Chun, Betty Huang, Pam Wong, and Dory Suntensor. A special mention goes to Dory for gaining a merit in the follow-on round and achieving such a high score. She is in the top 1.5% nationally. She has been invited to a special maths enrichment summer school, which is only open to the top mathematicians in the UK. So well done, Dory. If you'd like to come up for the certificates, please. Well done, it's excellent, outstanding, well done. We have four notices, starting with donuts, which will be sold for £1 each tomorrow, break time in the dining room. All proceeds go to Rwanda. I'm not sure who that one's from. Mrs. Chappio, please can all lower four students come to the hall at 10:55? That's the start of break today for an important meeting. That's 10:55, all lower fours, please, beginning of break. That's from Mrs. Chappio. This one's a bit small, I'll just do this to read it. This is from Miss Fox in the PE department. The B tennis teams for lower five, upper four and lower four were in action yesterday against Bournemouth School for Girls. The wind was swirling around, making conditions very tricky for everyone. However, the lower five, upper four recorded great wins in singles for both Frances and Eleanor. Then these girls paired up to win their doubles. This forces into a tiebreak shootout. This time, Emily paired up with Eleanor to win the final tiebreak 10-3. Well done to Olivia, who joined the team very late yesterday, filling in for us, and all the girls that played. The lower four team consisted of Annabelle, Helena, Lila, and Soraya, who unfortunately didn't record a win this time, however. All played very well in the conditions, and actually, as the game progressed, they all started to play better tennis. Hopefully, the next match will see them winning more games. Miss Fox says that she was totally engrossed in the play and forgot to take a photo, so sorry. Very importantly, the school, we have received a report about a person, a male adult, approaching pupils from another school to talk to them. I would just like to remind you that it's best not to get involved with a conversation with anyone you don't know when walking to and from school. And it's imperative that you report anything that might make you feel anxious or uncomfortable. And if possible, try to walk in a group. Thank you very much. I just remind you that when you return from assembly, you go back in silence, please. So thank you again very much. We'd like to lead on quietly.